Hello guys, in this video we are going to see how to fetch data from the MySQL database using the Java with the help of Eclipse editor. So first we need to import java.sql package, which provides the get connections, that means connections, interfaces, driver interfaces, statement interfaces, etc. So there are only 5 steps to connect the database and fetch, perform some operations on that. So in order to execute this program, first we need to load the driver of particular database. So I have already added one jar, that means we can see here MySQL connector. It is used to it helps to connect the backend to front end. So you can download it from the Google. So like from here simply you can search MySQL product connectors. You can see here MySQL connectors, then you go first, click on first link, then from here we will select JDBC driver for MySQL, download, simply download it and select operating system from this drop down and just download it and go to download page. And once it is downloaded, we will import it from here. Like click on project name, then build path, then add external archive, and just simply select the jar which is recently downloaded, that means connector jar. And I've already added, so I'll not add extra jar. So let's start. And jar will come inside the reference library, and here you can see that all the packages are available on this jar. So step one, we have created step one, step two, step three, step four and step five. So I'll run. I've written the query select a star from amp12. I'll execute this code and let's check what is getting the output. So Java class not found exception JDBC connection 2. Okay, I'll check the class name, then I'll run it. See amp1 id name salary, that amp id is a just label name and is salary is the column name. So amp id 101 102 103 name is this and salary is this one. You can check here there are only 3 records in the amp 112 date tables, that's why we are getting only 3 records. Okay, now here there is only one difference, two difference. If we will to fetch the data from the database, we will use execute query methods of a statement interface. It returns the result set and if we want to execute, that means like here if you want to perform updations, deletions, etc., then we will use execute update query, execute execute update once again this one. Here is integer rs1. Okay, we will use this object, execute update, and here we'll use update emp12 set name is equal to Raju. Where ID is equal to 103, but I am not going to perform this query. And this is the output. And if you want to fetch the data in reverse order, then we will use reverse.previous method. So it will return the reverse.previous method, but cursor is by default pointing on first position. So when we will execute this query, it will return empty because cursor still is focusing on position number one. So let's check it. What is getting output? See, we are getting empty. That means we are not getting any record. And to fetch the records, we will just use rs.last method to point the current cursor in the last index. Now we can see here. Wow, we are getting some records. Sandeep Loknath, that's. Thank you guys.